Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for Kubo and the Two Strings. What is so neat about this stop-motion animated picture from Leica is that the filmmakers immerse themselves in the Japanese culture. And even on this junket, we're actually here in Hollywood, in Beverly Hills, and they've got folks making origami, and they've got Shinobu making candy. And as he likes to say, he eats his mistakes. In the meantime, I hope you enjoy my cast interviews.
I use magic to tell stories.
If you must blink, do it now.
About epic battles, warriors, and monsters. But I had no idea my stories were actually true.
Well, your character has to convince her character that you're even needed on this big quest. If you all were involved in a big epic quest, what would you bring to the table?
We don't know anything about you.
Firing an arrow is hardly what I'd call impressive.
Literally the first time I've ever done it.
What would I bring to the table?
What would you do? How would you help?
What are you good with?
What am I good with?
You good with direction?
No.
You good with survival?
No. I think I'm good with survival, but horrible with direction, though. No.
Got it.
You'd have to handle all of that.
Yeah, not good at that.
I don't
either.
Know how to get from my house to the here by the shortest way, and I've only been here 24 years.
Oh boy, I don't know. I mean, I guess, you know what, maybe resilience and endurance. Like, I'm not good at a lot of stuff, but I'll sit through it. Like, I think there's something about South Africans that are just, like, you know, whether it's smarts or stupidity, but we can toughen things out. So I don't know if I would actually make it, like, a smoother experience, or...
But we'd last a long time.
But we would last
resilience.
A very, very long time. Don't give up.
I'm a skinny fella, so maybe I'm small, I'm quick, you know. I love my Gaelic, and I'm a quick enough player, so hopefully I'd be able to bring speed to the table.
All right, speed, and maybe you could fit into small spaces.
Exactly.
There you go.
This was where my father prepared for his quest.
Initially, whenever I read the script, it was very important for me to incorporate the relationship Kubo has with his mother, because I'm very close with my mother. My mother, she grew up in Sheffield. She moved over to Ireland whenever she was 19. She had my eldest brother. I think carrying on that story and the amount of work she's put in my life to get me to where I am today, you know, she's amazing. She helps me with everything I do, whether it be acting, whether it be Gaelic, whether it be schoolwork. She's a hardworking person, you know what I mean? So I think that's the story.
Must you play with your food?
Yes.
Your character is very maternal and throws out some nuggets like don't play with your food, you know, little tidbits for Kubo. Yeah. What is that mom phrase that you find yourself saying a lot right now?
Listen. Yeah. I'm at that age right now. Yeah. Wow. My goodness. I've used that word so much in the last 3 years. It's that age now where you just really need them to kind of like zero in and focus, and the listening bit is just, there's a lot of like, what did I just say?
Yeah.
Jax, listen.
Right. Does it work?
We're getting there. I have a feeling we will eventually end up somewhere really, really good. But it is very, very testing right now.
We're getting that in itself is a quest.
Woo!
There you go.
The patience. It's just like
I think I brought up a sore point. Yeah, we'll move on.
Typically, when people think of stop motion, they don't think of big, crazy, dynamic camera moves and martial arts battles. So it was a challenge to pull off. But, you know, the way we do things is that we fuse craft and technology. We take art, craft, science, and forward-thinking innovation to bring these things to life. So we have this character that's this giant monster skeleton thing that emerges from the shadows. And it's effectively, it's a 16-foot tall puppet. And it's kind of like a moving set. And we, you know, we built the whole thing at real scale, and it's a combination of technology that's holding it, moving it around. And then there's also things like a cable with a bucket and a sandbag holding it together. So it's this great combination of high tech and lo-fi merging together to bring these things to life.
I actually encourage people when they're done seeing the movie to go online and find the videos of how you put this together, because people don't get how time consuming these things are. And I would imagine there are some physical side effects to working for your company. I mean, how do you not have a bad back? How do you not have a masseuse on staff? I mean,
We actually do have a masseuse that comes multiple times a week. Because, yeah, as a stop-motion animator, you're contorting your body in all manner of weird positions trying to get these puppets to move properly. And so, you know, you go home at the end of the day and you've got aches and pains in all parts of your body, but it's also you're mentally exhausted as well, because I think one of the things that most people don't understand about stop-motion, it's like a chess game. You're trying to figure out, it's like this mathematical formula that you're going in your head, trying to figure out how you can move the puppet in a way that is planned, but it feels organic.
How important are tweezers to what you do? Because I was watching them put the tiniest of things on some of this. You must use those constantly.
We go through a lot of tweezers, yeah.
The sword unbreakable.
It could be a trap.
Allow me.
In voicing a Japanese samurai / beetle, the Texas-born and bred McConaughey is not the name that would come to mind.
But right.
Was it hard for him? I mean, I was waiting for an all right, one of those, and it never happened.
No, because, you know, it's a period fantasy. It's set in this fantastical place that's rooted in feudal Japan. But for the characters who are speaking, we can't have any accents. They have to be, you know, basically unaccented American English. Mm-hmm. And so for Matthew, you know, for Beetle, we wanted a character that was completely charming, that it was this kind of lovable rogue, but also had shades of vulnerability that could emote, show pain and can go through this entire range of human emotion. And so we need an extraordinary actor. And so Matthew was right at the top of the list.
How hard to get rid of the twang or that kind of...
Oh, it was just
easy.
Go to the sushi joint a few times. It was just and plus he was such a hero of that in his own mind. So I just put a little bit of a little bit different attack on the Beatles voice.
Plus, you are an Oscar winner. I'm sure that it wasn't that difficult.
Did that help?
Did that help?
I don't know.
You win the Oscar and just instantaneously you can do anything.
Well, the next day I could feel it.
Your quest is now my quest too.
You know, when we cast him in the role 3 years ago, he'd just done Mud, he'd done Killer Joe, he'd done Dallas Buyers Club, and so he'd show what an exquisite actor he is. His voice still has this incredible earthy quality, and in fact, there was at one point while we were recording the voices, he was not quite getting the quality of his voice that he wanted, and so he just disappeared. And I was like, "Where'd he go?" And I look up, and he's on the floor of the vocal booth, cranking out an inhuman amount of push-ups just to get the right quality in his voice. And he got up, and he just nailed the take.
I thought you were gonna say he's on the bongos, and then I would be really concerned.
We grow stronger. The world grows more dangerous. Life has a funny way of keeping things balanced.
These Leica movies, they don't take the easy way out. These things are time-consuming and take forever to make. What's that one thing that actually you would spend hours doing and it doesn't bother you?
Spring cleaning. I can kind of put a little something on in the background and let that last and not be interrupted. No one's coming over today. No, we're
gonna just cleaning?
And just getting stuff together.
I love that.
Just getting stuff.
I love that.
If you must blink. Do it now.
Hope you enjoyed the cast interviews for the film Kubo and the Two Strings. I have to say I've gotten a lot of pleasure watching Shinobu work with sugar and color and create these amazing pieces. And I think it's time to take a bite. Or should I wait till it cools off?
You can.
You saw the movie, right?
Yeah.
What'd you think?
It was a great movie.
It was a great movie.
Families, yes. Uh-huh.
I should mention, don't forget to like us on Facebook. You should too, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news promotions and giveaways. Can I have this?
Sure.
He's holding onto it quite tightly.